By popular demand, we are back in the B-52. A lot of you wanted to see the Navigator and EWO's compartment, so after crawling back through here, here we are. And we're in a spot they called the black hole. And you can kind of see why. You only got this tiny little window here and another one right across here. Now, who sat here was the radar navigator and the navigator. Now, the radar navigator, I'm in his position right here, was actually kind of the modern day bombardier. His job was to actually select the weapons, figure out the targets, the best way to get to the target, the best weapon to hit the target, and then drop the bombs. Now, the navigator, his job was to get from point A to point B without getting lost. That's kind of an unsung position. These guys were really good at what they did. In fact, they were really good at using the MA2 sextant. And if you don't know what that is, it's basically the same thing that old mariners used to take star and sun sightings. In fact, there's a little kind of dome right up here on the top of the plane that the navigator would crawl up there and take sun and star sightings to make sure that his radar was on track with what the stars and sun say. Let's move on up. So here we are in the EWO's chair, and an EWO is an electronic warfare officer. So when the B-52 was designed, it was designed to deliver nuclear weapons straight into the Soviet Union, and they had an amazing air defense system that consisted of radar, thousands of surface-to-air missiles, and over 1,000 fighter planes just to stop the B-52s. How does a B-52 punch through all of that? Well, that's what the EWO was supposed to do. He was supposed to be the guy that would monitor for radar, look for SAM launches, look for fighter missile launches, and then he could either pop out the chaff that we had seen, or he could even jam some of the radar. In fact, some of the guys used to turn on their radar or their jammer systems when they were over the United States just for fun. And what would that do? It would knock out television and FM radio for hundreds of miles. Now, when they got back to base, they would write it up as, oops, something went wrong. But I have to wonder if maybe they were doing it just to make sure that the system worked. Anyway, we want to thank you guys for tuning back into our B-52 episode. This is kind of, like we said, the in-betweener episode. But stay with us because we've got some pretty cool stuff coming up, and you're not going to want to miss it. We'll talk later. How do I get out of here?